UGD coming at you with the CZ-P07 in 9mm. It's the correct caliber. And this is your range review, guys. Yep, been to the range, shot this gun. Good gun. Yeah, it shoots well. Give you a quick rundown on this hot rod. 7.9 inches long, 1.46 right here at the dual decockers, 5.8 inches tall, 4.36 inch barrel. All in all, you know, it's got a great feel to it. The gun has a nice feel to it. I did enjoy shooting the gun. You know, the first magazine I run through this thing, I'm just getting rounds out. I just want to feel the gun and go quick and just see how the gun performs. And, you know, 17 plus one, boy, you're shooting forever on this hot rod. It shot well. I enjoyed shooting the gun. The recoil on it is very manageable, very comfortable. That low bore axis, that high grip you can get up on this thing. Yeah, those are all very pleasurable. Now, here are some negatives I found with this gun. The trigger. Yeah, the trigger system on this thing, I don't know. It has a little bit of take up. That doesn't bother me. It's just trying to find where that brake is. It's just, you know, I don't find that brake consistently. And not finding that brake, you know, I would rather know there's a little bit of a wall there and I'm about to hit that brake. And the same as in double action. You just don't know where that thing's going to finally brake each time. Now, the reset on this gun, yeah, it's not too bad. I mean, it's just a little bit, you know, not too bad on the reset on this thing. But again, trying to find that wall and hit that brake. And I would think that over time I could get used to it and get a feel for where that's at. My understanding is Cajun Gunworks does offer a whole trigger package you can throw in this thing. I looked it up online, over $300. That would mean you're, in that $700-$900 range on this hot rod. I don't know if it's worth that, but, I think over time a guy could get used to that. Another complaint I had was this mold line. Yeah, that mold line is pretty pronounced, and it's all the way through the gun, of course. But right here in the beaver tail, yeah, it's pretty sharp. You feel that. And of course, over time, maybe that would wear down, or I could take a little bit of time and take care of that. But come on, ZZ, that's not a big deal. Get somebody in there to work on that a little bit and make that a little bit cleaner. And then the last thing was that sight picture. It took a little bit of getting used to. That is a tall sight picture. This is my first gun with suppressor sights, so it just may be me that I just looked at it a couple times and went, took me a second to go ahead and think about what I was about to do. But I think for the money, this is a really good option for some guys, especially if you're a double action, single action guy. This is a really comfortable gun to shoot. It is a range gun. You can spend all day shooting it. Carry concealed? Maybe not. You know, I don't know. I think it's in that Glock 19 size with a little bit of plus on the barrel. The suppressor sights would probably keep me from even thinking about carry concealed. If this was a gun to go into rotation for carry concealed, you know, knock down and put some regular sights on that bad boy, or buy one that doesn't have the suppressor. Oh, last thing on this, the thread protector on the barrel, it gets loose. Yeah, you really got to put some effort in there and cinch it down. But, you know, all in all, I like the gun. It's a good shooting gun. I think it compares well with the Glock 19 as far as accuracy. I think it's a soft shooting gun. You know, there's a lot of positives going for it. So this is UGD coming at you with a range report on the CZ-P07 in 9mm. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you think I ought to learn how to shoot guns, hit the dislike and please subscribe.